Hi everyone.
Hello.
Welcome to the Sugar and Crumbs kitchen. Just at the right last second there, I remembered lights, so maybe you might have heard us go, oh, no lights. Anyhow, I am in the kitchen today with the fabulous Karen Davies. She's here, she's brought a fantastic display. So get those thumbs up, get those lovers up, and let Karen know how much, how excited you all are, because I've seen you've been writing on our page that you can't wait to see this session tonight. She has brought some amazing cakes with her, all with her new moulds, which we're really excited. So there's past, present and new.
There is.
So she's going to use a wide selection, and if she doesn't use them, she's going to show you some moulds. So we are really very chuffed. Are you excited?
Hope they are.
Yeah. So last time Karen was here, she never had so many cameras looking at her. So she's got five camera angles.
I just said, didn't I? It's like a real TV studio now. It's like, so I might pick things up and put them in the wrong direction. So there might be a lot of waving, pushing me around a bit.
John will be going like that, that. Yeah,
well, hopefully I'll get used to it.
So Karen's not been in the kitchen with all these cameras. So we're going to try and get as many angle shots as we can. We've also got a microphone in the kitchen, so do let me know. I know you can all hear me. God almighty. So I know you can all hear me, but we've put an extra camera in the kitchen as well, so hopefully you can hear that. And then I do want you to like and share. It's very important for us to like and share. So if you're watching us on Facebook, please make sure you share this session. Please make sure you like it. Please keep all positive comments. Remember, we're in our own kitchen. This is not a sales kitchen. This is mine and John's private kitchen in our own home. We do these demos free of charge. We come to you, we want to show you new products that are all on our website. So our website is www.sugarandcrumbs.co.uk. Maria, as usual, has put all the links at the top of the feed. So when the feed finishes, all the links are there. There's six of us in the kitchen, so we may have to open the doors every now and again to let some air in, because it's absolutely boiling in here already. Do remember, we are on the ambulance run, so if you hear the ambulance going past,
it's like where we live.
So we are actually on the main road, believe it or not. So if you do hear the ambulances go past, it is the ambulances.
It's not coming for us, normally.
So you sort of sit there like, ooh, da, 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 da. So make sure you share. Anyhow, so you're going to wonder what this tray of goodies is. Can you see this tray of goodies, John? So I've meant to say, in the kitchen is Maria as usual. We've got John and we've got Barry Davies. He's watching tonight. We can't get him cake decorating, but he is observing. He's been helping out load everything.
He thinks he can do it.
Does he?
Yeah.
They all think they can do it.
No, some he can, some he can.
So, can we see these colours here, John?
Yes.
Right, okay. So we've got a brand new range of colours here. You won't see them all. They are on the website, Maria. Am I going backwards or forwards?
Right.
This way? Perfect. So basically in the colour range, Laura and I have been in the office. We are frantically trying to get them all on the website. Karen is going to use them tonight. Okay, so she's not going to use all the colours, but she's going to try and use as many as she can. So there's gels in 30 grams. I haven't put the pictures on yet. So if you are looking, everything by tomorrow lunchtime will be on the website. So everything's listed. It's just maybe not all the images and not all the content, but prices are there. Everything else is there. Which camera am I looking at, Maria? Yeah.
Just that one.
So we've changed. Right. Okay then. So, so we've got all these beautiful shiny dusts. Okay. They're all absolutely amazing. We've got all these gels. These are 30 gram gels. We've got these amazing pens, and you know what? I know Karen's going to love these amazing pens. Mm-hmm. They are a really nice, can we
a
see that one?
Point, isn't it?
It's a really nice fine point, and it's beautiful to write with, okay? And then I've not actually put these on the website yet, but I'm so looking forward to these. I don't actually know how to airbrush, but look at these amazing airbrush colours, okay? Every one of these colours is all edible, and they're suitable for all diets. So if you're vegan, vegetarian, halal diet, you can use any of these colours.
So they're all airbrush colours?
These are all airbrush colours, aren't they amazing?
Yeah. Oh, wow.
They're absolutely beautiful. Now the airbrush colours are not on the website yet, but they will be on by lunchtime or by tea time tomorrow. But Laura and I are working like lunatics, so make sure you look out for these. Having said that, the Colour Splash range, are we back over here, John? So the Colour Splash range, you know, is my all-time favourite, but I do get asked, are anything suitable for vegans, vegetarians? I've seen this range, I've spoke to the company. All the information will be up on there tomorrow, but these are suitable for all types of diets. They're apparently allergen free. So I'm going to take these away and I'm going to let Karen get on with her demo. So don't forget those love hearts, big kisses, and make sure you've got some for me as well.
Oh, thanks, Carol.
You're welcome.
Right, I'm just going to go through the cakes. Is this in the right position? This is the first one to hold to camera. I'm not going to demonstrate the Easter chick and Easter bunny tonight. It's so close to Easter now, maybe you're all prepared, I don't know. But I think the first time I was here, I did some cookies, some moulded cookies. Is that right? The first time.
Okay.
And these are great for last minute Easter, little Easter cookies. You know, if you've got the children coming round at the weekend, or Easter egg hunts, you could have some cookie hunts, you could do all sorts of things. The recipe for the cookies, I think Carol said, is it on your Facebook page or your website?
It's on our recipe website.
Right,
but on the recipe. We can get that posted up later.
Yeah, Carol will put the link to that on the Facebook page later for making the cookies. So you just mould the cookie dough the same as you would the sugar paste that you use in the moulds, and colour the same. I don't colour the cookie dough before I bake it or anything. Just comes out, you know, golden, a light golden brown, and then use petal dusts and paints to decorate your little Easter bunnies and chicks. So that cake, it's got our woodland bark around the bottom. It has got some of our buttercream flowers on as daffodils, which I'll try and show you later, because you can, the actual flower, this little blossom mould, is quite big, but you can put smaller pieces of paste in to get smaller flowers. And we've just got, of course, the little Cadbury's eggs just added to that there. And also there's the new, the Wild Meadow. I've used some of the flowers off that, which I'm going to show you very soon how to use. That's one of our new moulds. It's very popular. So that's the first cake anyway. Now, I'll bring this one over next just because I'm right next to it. Excuse me, I need to apologise as well. I have had a cough about the last 3 months, I think.
I forgot to tell her. I am sorry. So Karen has to apologise that she is poorly, but I told her.
No, I'm not.
She's still to get her body over here. So she has done.
So I've got cough sweets in my pocket, water down here, so, but I might still have to run away with coughing later, I don't know. Anyway, this cake, this gorgeous teapot cake, was made by Christina Ludlam, who has been here, hasn't she, to demonstrate. And she makes fantastic cakes. We just love this. This is our new crochet mould and our crochet flowers. The crochet mould we've just made a bit bigger so you can do more with it. About five years ago, we brought out a range of knitted and crochet moulds. So we've got, here's the crochet flowers, there's crochet bows, and so on. And hearts, crochet hearts as well. So here she's made a teapot cozy, they're called, aren't they? Haven't had one for years.
Right.
Yeah, a little piece of Battenberg cake there on the word mum. Okay. So there's so many cakes.
Barry was looking worried about how many I brought with me.
Right, the Wild Meadow. This might be a bit tricky. I'm not sure how much of this will fit onto the camera. Where I need to put it.
This is amazing, isn't it? All your moulds are amazing.
Just actually put it down.
Just put
there.
It down.
Yeah.
Okay,
and then maybe I'll spin it round.
Oof, good, because it's heavy. Right, before I start about the moulds and the pieces on here, this was actually just airbrushed a little bit, so those new colours, I was wishing I'd had those colours.
Right.
And I did a little bit of airbrushing on this. There's just a few colours on it. In the background, and then we've used Alice as designed this Wild Meadow mould.
It's beautiful.
I can sort of, will that, is that okay there?
Perfect.
Yeah, you can all see it there. So we've actually got this big piece here is the grass, like a grass border. So of course you can trim that to make it whatever height you wish, as you can see she's done here on these two borders on the cake. And then we've got the flowers here and leaves. So there's lavender, a long thin fern leaf, some mimosa, some wheat and barley, and we've also got here some little gypsophilia, There's a single gypsophila and a little group of them there. But again, with these, I'll show you later, you can make them smaller than this as well. I wanted to do a gypsophila mold after I did Alice's wedding cake when I made them all by hand. And I dread to think how long it took. And they looked, you know, there was thousands of them, and then you take them all together and you've hardly got any. So I'm pleased with that. And I do think I'll be able to wire them as well. So that's the new one, and that's the first mold I'm going to show you in a few minutes' time. And we've also got the butterflies here. And I think she put little mosquitoes on as well, off from our butterfly mold.
So all the molds are on our website, guys. If they're not on the website, they will be on the website by tonight before I go to bed. I think there's one or two I might have missed.
It's going to be late night.
Karen's brought all the stock, so don't worry, anything here.
I love this.
Oh yeah, you like this one, didn't you, when you saw this? Okay, well the side design here is off our rustic cable knit mold. So thinking about the colours of the rainbow, I've just done all different colours there around the side, and then we've got the unicorn on top. Now all these figures that you're going to see, you just basically model as you would normally with your cones or your sausage shapes or a ball of paste, and then cover them with the crochet or the knitted piece to give that knitted toy effect. So I had to do a unicorn because they're so popular at the moment, and he's got like a nice mane there with all the matching colours from the side, the pieces on the side of the cake. So I'm going to probably make the unicorn later.
Absolutely beautiful.
You're going to make that unicorn tonight?
Yeah, yeah.
Hopefully.
Hopefully you'll be leaving him behind then. Me and Maria are going to keep him.
Time on. Oh. Right, and here we've got an elephant. He's covered with the knitted piece. This one I do recommend making the head the day before because of the shape of the trunk, and you want it to stay up and not sort of droop down. So the head I do make the day before and let it set. Round the sides here we've got the patchwork squares. Now this is a new mold to Carol, and she will have it in the next day or two and on the website. Yeah. So that with this one I've just molded it in grey, and then I've used a square cutter and cut out some squares and then replaced them with the blue colour. Okay. And then
that mold will be on the website in the morning. If you order it, it will just go out a day or two late, that's all, but it will be with your fairy stuff.
Right, now this is another new mould here on the side, the chunky knit.
I love that.
It's nice,
beautiful,
isn't
it?
Yeah, it is
when
nice.
I saw that the first time, yeah. I love it.
Yeah, yeah. And we've got a rabbit again covered with the knitted piece, and she's wearing a little crochet bow. And I've also decorated it with some flower buttons off our button mould. Okay, it's nice in the pale pink. And then to this side. Now, I can't believe this teddy bear wasn't attached to the cake when I got here. He was sat over here. Oof. Yeah, I didn't realise I hadn't attached him to the cake. So again, he's just covered. He's got little dungarees on as well. And he's holding the little teddy. That's our small teddy bear mould. And the sides, there's the crochet piece and the buttons and the cable round the bottom. Okay.
Jackie Richards has got her wild meadow. In fairness to Jackie Richards, she was the one that she messaged me and said, Carol, where's the new Karen Davies molds? I went, I don't know. My phone, Karen. So Jackie got hers in first. Well done, Jackie.
Excuse me. Right, this cake, this bottom tier, has got the chunky rib. Okay, round the sides. This is another new one. Now, Barry thinks these molds are a bit confusing, the names.
I have to agree.
The people who knit will know, will understand.
I have to agree.
Completely,
I think. Chunky rib, chunky
knit. Yeah. So if you get the wrong mold, yeah, in the bag.
Yeah, well let me show you the difference in the molds first of all. Okay, so the knit is very fine. That's the knit that you've just seen the teddy bear dressed in the knit, okay, and then the chunky knit, it's the same pattern but a lot bigger,
yeah,
you know. So, and then the rib,
yeah, it's the chunky rib and the chunky knit,
chunky rib
and chunky knit.
And well, the chunky rib and chunky knit.
My lads in the warehouse having a nightmare.
We're having a staff meeting,
they
tomorrow.
Are packed, they are packed, and the names are clearly on the leaflets, yeah. So. But Yeah, the people who knit will understand completely. So, okay.
You lost that battle then, Barry, did you?
Right, the other thing about this cake, I mean, I've put the buttons again round the top tier, but on the top, I hope this is stuck secure, are these little baby booties. Okay, which hopefully time allowing,
so
I want to make these as well. Yeah. Okay, right. So, if you have any questions, of course, we'll answer as we go along.
Absolutely. So guys, just shout out. I'm not shouting out names tonight because there's so many viewers, but you know what? Give us a wave, give us a love heart, let us know you're here. Let Karen know you're here, and if you're a newbie, shout out where you are. And if you're not a newbie, just say hello. That'd be fantastic.
Oh, okay. Right, I'm going to start with the new Wild Meadow mould. Okay, so what shall I do first? Right, let's get some green paste. I'll do the lavender, so you can see the lavender, because I think that's going to be very, very popular.
Karen, make sure you tell them about your amazing sugar.
Oh yes, what I'm using.
And I told them never to buy marshmallow if they're on a diet, because that never gets to anybody. It's so good.
No, so this is a pack of the vanilla. So like Carol said, we've got two flavours, vanilla or marshmallow. And they are very, very nice to eat.
Elaine Lawton understood your knitting. Thank you.
Oh, good, Elaine. Thank you, Elaine.
Okay. She can't pack on them.
So, I'm glad it's not just us who have issues.
So, I've coloured some of the paste with green paste colour. Okay. Ready to go in the mould. Now, this paste works straight from the packet. I've coloured it, like I just said. You don't have to add Tyler or CMC to it, which is really useful. So because it's a long, thin piece here, I've made a long, thin piece of paste. And I always make sure my fingers aren't sticky when I press it in, because it does come out so easily.
Karen, can we just go?
That way, sorry. Yeah.
Yeah. You're talking to this camera now.
Thank you.
Which one? Or this one? Or this one?
John will let you know.
It's like being on BBC One. Okay, so as you see there, I've just pushed in like that, in and down. As I push in, I'm cleaning up the edges. And I think I said I dusted it with corn flour, didn't I?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, a lot of people ask is why you use corn flour, not icing sugar. The only reason I sort of think, and it sounds quite logical, like a lot of people say, oh, if there's any damp in the mould, the icing sugar sticks to it, or whatever. But I think that if I put icing sugar in here and then I press the paste in, the paste is sticky, it just absorbs the icing sugar, but it doesn't absorb the corn flour. So it's still going to release really easily. And normally you turn the mould over, don't you, and sort of bend it and they fall out. But this, I tend to just bend it and just take it off. See, so it's really easy to do.
I must admit, your moulds do fall out, don't they?
Yeah.
Sugar paste in, and it's so easy.
Yeah.
You don't get any sticky bits in there, right?
Exactly. It's the right sort of paste with the right sort of mould. And you know, you're laughing, it's just so easy. You don't want to, if I'm making a cake and I'm having just lavender, a nice plain white cake, and I'm just having lavender around the sides, and I need to make, say, 50 pieces, 100 pieces. You don't want to say, oh, put it in the freezer now, so I can take it out. You know, you can't. It's got to work. So again, you see, you just bend it and you can just take it out. Now you can dry them straight or dry them with a little bit of shape to them, a little curve. Okay.
Somebody says, why didn't we do the sugar paste in colours?
Oh.
Exactly the same reason why we don't do our icing sugars in colours. It's a nightmare.
There's so many.
We haven't got enough shelves.
We don't have the space.
It's the variant, though, isn't it? If you tried to do pink, they'd want hot pink, baby pink, rose pink.
You could just
colour and eat yourself.
That's it, there's so many shades. In your lovely colours, Carol, do you have, I think you do actually, a purple. A nice,
I do have a beautiful,
I think,
purple.
I did see purple before.
Yeah, you did.
Excuse me, I'm just going to have a little drink of water.
There's an eggplant purple and a bishop purple.
Mm. And, oh gosh,
you need any shiny ones. So a few people have asked about the pens. Can they paint eyes on with them? Yes, they can. They're really fine.
Yeah, but I would say
when you paint it dry.
Yes, Oh, Carol, beat me to it.
I'm getting good. It shows that we made intentional.
Yeah, because you imagine if your paste is still soft and you're trying to
use the pen.
Yeah, the pen is just going to sink into the paste. So now, when you're using powder colours,
just let me ask: is your paste suitable for vegans?
Right, I should know this, shouldn't I? I can read out the ingredients on the back of this: sugar, glucose syrup, vegetable fat, humectant, E422, emulsifier, E471, thickener, E415, E466, natural flavouring, preservative, E200, food acid, E330. May contain traces of almonds.
Yeah. So I don't know.
No.
You'll have to find out.
I did. I'm sure I've been asked that. I think it is.
Yeah,
I think
Barry said it is. We'll blame Barry, but he says
it is. I will check tomorrow and get back to you. Double check.
Well, everybody, Karen, is giving you massive reviews. They're just saying they all love your moulds. Oh. They love the cakes. They can't wait for you to show them some goodies. Mm-hmm. They're loving it all, and they're all just saying that they've spent a fortune, but I'm sure you're all happy to spend some more. At sugarandcrumbs.co.uk.
To save a few quid, because we've got some more ones coming up.
Have you got some more?
No, there's new, yes, some more new things.
Let's be back here with them,
David. We will. Now this piece of lavender, I'm just brushing the powder on dry, and on this piece I'll paint it on so you can see the difference. When you brush powders on, you dip into the pot and then dab it off in the lid so you're not wasting lots of it. You see there, I've just got that little piece of colour, that little patch of colour, and there's no loose powder there because it's just such a waste. You're just going to throw this away, you know, afterwards. So now when you finish that, obviously it just goes back in the pot. So I'll now open a dark green, take the lid off. Very carefully. And then just get another brush. Again, dab in the lid, rub on the paper, and then just add the green. So I've put the purple at the top here on these little, I don't know, little, they're not really flowers, are they? What do you call these on lavender? They usually have some sort of fancy name, don't they? Parts of flowers and plants. And I'm not that well up on
I have no idea flowers
botanical sort of things. But you see there now, you've got the different shades on there. I quite like the brushed on colour because it looks so soft and natural. But if you want to paint now, I use isopropyl alcohol. You can use water. Oh, it's a lid. I'm gonna fight with it. You can use water to paint with, it just takes a little longer to dry. So again, now mix your colour in your lid, not in your paint palette, because you just wash this, don't you throw it away, wash it, but your lid, the colour will dry in that lid and you can reuse it. That's a Marion Frost tip, that.
Right, can I just tell, Geraldine is looking on the website for the knitted elephant. Geraldine, we don't sell the actual mould, you have to make it. There is some work involved. So Karen is going to show you how to make one or two of these moulds tonight. And basically, they're all sort of very similar. So you do have to watch how she makes them.
Where have I just put the oats there? I couldn't see through
a few people are letting Geraldine know.
Aww. So I'm just painting a little bit of the purple on. Top, cross. I'm just doing it across the top. What you would need to do is pick it up and make sure you've got the sides as well. Okay, but I've just literally done the top there. So it'll be nice and quick. Let me put it on a clean piece of paper so you can see them a bit clearer there. Okay.
Right, anybody who doesn't want to see the comments, just swipe to the left on your Facebook page. So if you want it, I know that you're all absorbed and some of you can't see what Karen's doing because of the speech bubbles. If you go on your screen and swipe to the left, I'm sure it's the left or the right, you'll actually lose all the comments and then you can go back and read them later if you're interested.
Right, I want to try something I've not tried yet with this mould. I want to try doing a wired fern leaf.
Sometimes when I'm demonstrating.
A wired family?
Yes.
I know, right?
Yeah. Mm. I might regret it in a few minutes now. I'm sure it'll work.
At least you're doing it early now.
Yeah. I just think this would be so nice. Because if you do wired flowers, sometimes it's the things, you know, you want things to go in between your roses and daisies or whatever it is you're making. So there you see a very thin piece of paste, cornflower on your fingers again, and press in. Now this is the fern, little fern leaf, and I'll need to make two of these.
So hopefully you've all got rid of your comments if you just want to watch, because I know a lot of you are saying that there's so many comments you can't see. Just swipe to the left.
So there's one fern leaf out. Now the next one.
Everyone's saying how fabulous you are, Karen. And what it's doing where you're showing, it's going over the screen.
What's that? Sorry.
Well, they're doing when everybody's typing their comments.
Oh,
because
see.
I'm looking on the computer, my comments are on the right hand side. But those people looking on phones and iPads, all their comments are coming up, so they're not seeing. So I'm just saying, swipe to the left.
Oh,
we'll all be singing that by the end of the night. Or maybe swipe to the right, Harry says.
We're not good with left and right, are we, Carol?
No.
There's a tiny little bit too much paste there at the end, you see. So if I just press down my thumb like that, take it off. And then just tidy it up by brushing back into the mould. And then just
swipe
bend again, take out. Now, I've got a piece of wire.
Swipe to the right.
Sounds like a song or a dance. So I've got a piece of wire, okay. And I will cut that to probably about twice the length of the fern. If you want to, you could curve it a little bit. And then take one of your fern leaves, turn it over. So I want it about the same shape as the wire there.
Oh, some clever, Tanya's clever, she's got hers linked to the telly. So she's got hers, no problem. She's watching hers on the big screen.
Yeah. That's great.
This is a professional watcher, aren't you, Tanya?
With a smart TV, is that what they're called?
So, I made a mistake. It looks like it's swiped to the right, guys.
So, if I lay the wire there now.
And if you turn your image landscape, your image becomes bigger. Don't hold it portrait, hold it landscape.
And then we'll put the leaf
on it. Sorry, Carol. Yeah, Karen.
It's all right, don't worry. It's all very technical. Over the top there.
What size wire are you using?
The thinnest I had, the smallest wire I had, where's the packet? I think it's a 28. Yes, a 28. So it's very fine. Oops, butterfingers tonight.
Jilly Bean Jewel says, swipe to the left, swipe to the right, do the okey-cokey and you turn her around.
I've missed the glue off the end here of this.
So, Sherry has just joined us. She says she's missed a chunk. Will it be saved to our page? Yes, it will. Only after the live feed, it'll be saved to our page, and you'll be able to watch it on YouTube tomorrow.
Okay, now I'm putting some green powder on this, although it's not dry yet. I would really rather leave it to dry. But you would... Ooh. When you brush the powder colour, you see the pattern from the leaf a little bit more. Okay, so that would be to go in between your roses when you've got wired flowers. Okay, and on this mould I've also got the, wrong mould, jip as well.
So just to let you know, Laura from the office is actually on the live feed. She's answering questions, because I'm trying to read them, so she's answering them. Well done, Laura, thanks for joining us tonight.
I'm going to open the white.
I don't pay him for night time, Jim.
Can we have it closer so we can really see?
It's
obviously quite small.
What I'm doing now is very small. I mean, this is even smaller. Maybe it's the wrong thing to do. But
no, what can we lift it up on for us to see? What can we lift it, make it higher?
I don't think that
we have to think about or something.
Maria can hold his phone actually.
Ah, right.
You sure? Yeah. As well as Phil?
You're good, aren't you? Okay. Or do you want Barry to hold it?
No, it's okay.
You got it.
Yeah? Okay.
So I'm going to use this little, the smaller jib here. And you can either put corn flour in or your pearl luster. So tap that out.
That's better.
And then you just take a little ball of paste. Like this. Drop it in. Now, if you want it to come out on your finger, you can, don't put any corn flour on your fingers. Oh, press really hard and it comes out on your finger, okay? So that's very easy to do. It's probably hard to see the pattern on it. Just lots of little petals. So I can actually make that smaller. Just put corn flour in again. You can put in a tiny, tiny ball of paste like this. Press hard. Now it didn't come out that time on my finger, but you just bend, see it's loose, it's not stuck. It's just loose. So just turn it over and it falls out. Okay, so there it is. So you can see how small it is next to my finger. How tiny. It's hard, it looks quite bright. It's hard to see the shadows of the petals really there. But these, again, I think you could do them wired. Now it should, I've got a pack of white wires there, but I'm just gonna be lazy and use the green, because you don't really want to see the green through the flower, so you'd use a white wire on this. So I'd be a bit scared of doing the very tiny one, but I think this size you would be okay. So your ball of paste needs to be really just too big this time, instead of it being flat and level. So put some corn flour in. Press, and it's gone over the edge. So just push the paste back up and pinch it like this. And then take your piece of wire, and you see I've put a little tiny hook, whether you can pick that up on the end there. And then just brush it with a little glue. And then push it in. And then just hold it and pinch to take it out. And you've got a little wired jib as well. So if you do a few of those and bunch them together, about five in a little spray, they're great to go with your roses as well. So you know, so you can do other things with them. Now, what's that? I know, last after Alice's wedding cake last year. That's what we needed.
Alice's wedding cake is beautiful. Right. So somebody just asked a question, Paula. She says, "Do you use any other sugar paste other than your own to cover cakes, Karen?"
Right. Sometimes I think my paste is quite firm, so I'll always be honest. I think it's more difficult for me now because I've got sort of pains in my shoulders, my elbows, and I think repetitive strain injuries, or whatever you want to call them. So I think covering anything 10 inch or over, I find quite hard work with this because it is very firm. I mean, it does the smaller pieces, it does soften, and a lot of people do use it for the bigger cakes.
Yeah.
So,
I know a lot of people use it.
Oh, yeah. But,
and they don't find it as difficult as you say, Karen.
No.
Because I always tell them that you say it's difficult, and they don't find it.
Just on larger
bigger
cakes.
Bigger muscles enough.
Yeah, just on large cakes. Small cakes are fine. It's no trouble at all.
I was going to say, I can take out 10 men, but I can't roll the sugar.
Oh dear. Right, I can't remember if I put corn flour in there or not. Let's just do it again. Oh, that could be next week's show. So there we go, piece of paste there to put in to this piece here. So again, I'm just pressing in and pushing like this. Alice has just done today, she's decorating a lovely cake, like a beach themed cake, and using these as sort of grasses at the beach. She's used the driftwood and put a little path and a fence. These grasses,
I don't know where you get your ideas
really
from. You're so
lovely.
Good,
you just never stop thinking, do you, about it? Again, that'll just come out like that. And again, set it, you can dry it with a slight shape to it, always looks really nice. Okay, and these look nice done in like a creamy colour, and then brush your green on afterwards, but I'll just do it now with the green. Rubbing the powder into the paper. remover, and you see the detail comes out a lot better. It's nice having these flat brushes to dust with as well, because you can really get in between things and give it that shape and more 3D sort of look. Okay. When Alice dusts and paints things like this, she always adds like white, little white highlights and things. Makes it look really all artistic and realistic. And you know, I'm just brushing the powder on. And but it depends how many of them you've got to make, doesn't it? Sometimes how much you can do. Do as little or as few as you want. So the other piece here is pretty much the same to do. And we just got this one, I'll show you quickly. This one we call Mimosa. It just looks like there's lots of tiny flowers on it. So if you do it in green, and then you can paint the flowers whatever colour you want, really. So we'll do it with some yellow. We've got some nice yellows here.
You said that little one looks like that Christmas wreath that you've done.
Oh, yeah. Well, this would be nice, sort of like harvest festival, you know, doing like the wheat sheaves, yeah, and things like that. There's so many things you can do with this one. So there we go. We could put a little bit green on this first.
If you bring your colours to the right, Karen, when you go over...
My right?
Yeah. When you go over, your hand keeps going in front of the camera. So if you keep your colours to the right...
Oh, these to the right, yeah, okay.
Then when you brush, they can, yeah, see them. Okay. As long as you see your hand keep going in like that.
In the way. In the way.
It's all right. We have to do everybody who comes in the kitchen every week.
Yeah,
you know,
it's getting
we
used
think,
to.
John and I think we have the camera sorted out, and it's then they're left-handed.
This is a nice yellow, light yellow. That's lovely. Nice creamy yellow colour. So I'll just take the lid off again. These are all brand new. So
Chris Lloyd has asked a question. Chris, you've said, what is the mould called on our website? But can you just tell me which mould you're referring to? Karen's demoing all her new moulds tonight. She's got 4 brand new moulds out. And the one that she's demoing with at the moment is called Wild Meadow.
Right, so I've just mixed some alcohol with the yellow. I've done it quite thin and runny, the colour. As you can see there. So I'm just dabbing at the areas with the flowers on. Missed a bit there at the bottom. So you can, when you've done that, you can actually go darker or lighter with some colour on it.
When you add those bits of colour, it really brings it up, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah. And I've used this on the Easter cake where the little bunny was going into the tree. I've sort of arched it like this and put it over the his burrow.
So Karen's using all the new colours tonight, by the way. So all the new colours that are in, she's using all those on her moulds this evening.
Right, I've just got a little bit of the sparkle, name was it?
Let's say
sparkling white. Fractal.
Fractal.
Is that how you say it?
Fractal.
Fractal.
I can say fractal. And John keeps correcting me. You know I never get it right.
So
I decided to shut up until you asked me.
Little highlights there.
The link's on the page.
Okay.
I've not done them as a complete set because there's so many of them. And if I put all of them as a complete set, but if you message me and tell me you want a complete set, I'll do you a little discount on them.
Right, I'm just going to move those out of the way. So I think I've covered more or less. There's a leaf here as well that I haven't shown you.
So Carol said, what alcohol did you use to make the paint?
Isopropyl alcohol.
Yep.
It's a very strong alcohol, but it completely evaporates. So you're just left with the powder colour on top of the sugar paste. So you're not actually eating or drinking strong alcohol.
No. So Carol, Laura may be able to give you the link afterwards for the, repeat it again. I just call it rejuvenated.
Yeah,
it's so
the same thing, isopropyl alcohol.
How much is the meadow mould?
$17.99.
Oh, John knows that one. Proud of John. Look at you, John, in there. $17.99 is the Wild Meadow mould.
Sorry, just having a drink for my throat.
Don't worry, Karen.
I'm getting very dry.
Yeah.
Now, I just quickly want to show you something. I think last time I was here, or the time before, did I show you the buttercream flowers?
You did show
Must have been last time. Because with this, you can actually, like I did then with the jip, you can actually put smaller pieces of paste in to make smaller flowers.
Yeah. That's a good thing about that mould. You've only got 12 flowers on, but when you think of the smaller versions you can make, and not everybody realises they can actually make a smaller version.
No.
So it's good that you show them that. Have you got a close up of that, John?
No, I need to come this way.
Right, okay. So, this way. So, what Karen's shown you from the buttercream flowers mould, even though you get 12 different moulds on there, you can actually make smaller versions of that bigger flower, the rose and the small one as well.
So that's the daisy, and you can see I haven't filled it, haven't put as much paste in. So it comes out, you've got small daisy, okay, instead of the larger daisy. So there's some here that I've made earlier, so you see there the difference in the size.
How long does the flowers take to dry when you've painted them?
I think of it as set. Rather than dry, you just want them to set. So they're still soft inside, but they're okay to use. You know, they're firm enough to handle and to paint. I usually colour them pretty much straight away now. You know, I'll paint the colour into the centre. And then that one's been it's been dried in the dimple-shaped foam, you know, just to give it a little bit of shape.
So the colours we're using tonight, I've seen that Marge has just asked, it's a brand new range that's just been launched, and I never get the pronunciation right. John, would you like to say it for me?
Fractal.
Fractal colours. And there's a whole range, there's pens, there's airbrush, there's gels, there's dust, there's shiny dust. They are on the website, but not all the information and not all the images are there. But Laura and I from the office have been working like crazy on them today because we only confirmed the order over the weekend. They arrived today, so I have to thank Fractal. They got them over to us as rapid as they could. And I will let all the prices are on, so if you want to guess the colour, you can do. But everything will be on there by tomorrow night.
Right, the next mould I'm going to show you is the butterfly and insect mould, because this we've used with the wild meadow mould, because obviously it goes really nicely. The one thing I forgot to show you then was the grass border I meant to demonstrate, so I can go back to that later if we've got time, but that's just a big piece of paste rolled in, but I'll try and get back to that. Now on here we've got some butterflies, dragonflies, a bee, a ladybird. The butterflies are sort of more, they're not realistic, they're very ornamental. There is one here that we use that is the most realistic to paint and put some colour on. So I'll just put some paste into here. This is probably too much, but I'll just show you how to take some off. So just press in all the time, thinking about keeping it flat and level with the back of the mould and not going over the edge. And then I usually work the excess paste into one corner and then just make sure I've got cornflour on my thumb and take it off. Because these moulds are very firm, that will work just with your thumb. You don't need to use a knife. So we'll just turn that over. Flex the mould and it comes out, and then I would leave that to set against even just another mould. You can just lay it against the side like that, okay, and then it's ready to paint. So I've got one here. Well, that's the smaller one over here. So if I just quickly make this one to show you this one here.
So Karen speaks very quietly. Is our new microphone working, guys?
Love to shout.
Yeah, no, it's okay. So what do you think of our new microphone? Because I know you can always hear me, no matter where I am in the kitchen. But can you all hear Karen very well? Yes. Just send me some thumbs up. That's all I need to know.
Okay, there's the little one. And again, you just bend the mould, turn it over, and it falls out. So they're the two, they're both nice to use with the wild meadow because like I say, they're so realistic. And then I've got one here.
The butterfly mould will be on at the end of the session, Catherine. Karen's brought it with her tonight and I forgot to put it on the website, so it will be on at the end of the session. G-
give me, when the end of the session comes, give me an hour and it'll be on. I just need to help Karen and Barry load up the car and then I will get it on. So I'm glad you can all hear Karen loud and clear. Our microphone is working.
Aww.
Maybe I'll have to tone it down.
When I cough. You can turn it down when I cough.
Oh dear. They can all hear you loud and clear.
Aww. Getting just a bit hot and sticky, so I'm just putting a little bit of corn flour on my fingers because the end of this little dragonfly is so thin and little there. I'll just put a little bit more paste over it, I think. Yeah, very sticky tonight. There we go.
If I've missed any moulds, they will be on the website tonight, so don't panic, they will be there. Come back in the morning, go to bed, have a think about what you're going to order, and come and smash our website with sales.
And there's our little dragonfly. So these are nice even if you just brush the petals with luster or paint them. This is a really nice white luster, actually.
My friend from school who used to go to school with Paul Vinnie Main. I can hear you, Carol.
Aww.
He can hear me in Ashton. You know I can only whisper across 9 fields, Paul.
Yeah, that's a lovely sparkly white, isn't it, that they do?
Yeah, it's a beautiful white,
nice.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm actually very impressed with those colours in fairness.
They are, they're really nice.
Yeah.
And again, you can just dry that at an angle. Okay, so it dries in that shape. Okay. So, they're the butterflies. Oh, there's some dragonflies here that I've painted as well. There's another one there. So they're nice done in different colours. To go on to the
dragonfly.
Yeah. Aww. So now we'll get a bit more into it now. We'll do I'll make the unicorn now.
Mm,
so we just need a little tidy up.
Yeah.
Because I do tend to just keep getting stuff out.
I hope you're gonna leave that unicorn behind. That's the second time I said it, Karen.
Okay. You can have the one I make now. You can keep
the one that you make now.
Yeah. We've got photographer coming in tomorrow.
Yeah, you can keep the
other one. So we need
the other
one.
We have to make the second one in a rush.
Right, now we need a board to put him on. Board. So like I said before, you're actually making the shape, his body first, and then covering it with the knit or crochet. And the best thing to you've got to remember with these is that when you're covering the body, the head, the legs, it's going to look bigger. So if you make them to look slightly thin, slightly too small, that's the best thing to do. Otherwise, they end up a bit sort of dumpy. And
do you need to share anything while you make this?
No, fine. So. It doesn't matter. Now, normally you're trying to get rid of the creases and the folds because they look unsightly, and you put that at the bottom so you can't see it. With this, it doesn't matter so much. Okay, now I'm just going to check the size. That is quite a bit smaller actually than that one. I'll go a little bit bigger. Just add a bit more to him, and again, see, it doesn't really matter. As long as you've got the right shape. If you wanted to, you could add tylo to this. I'm just going to round it off a little bit at the bottom so I can tuck.
So somebody's just asked me if they order all the moulds, okay, is there going to be a discount? If you private message me afterwards, I will be able to manage a little discount depending on how many moulds you order. So private message me, I won't answer you tonight, I'm in work at 7 o'clock tomorrow. So message me then, message me tonight or tomorrow, and I will come back to you.
Right, I'm going to do a knitted unicorn because I've got a crocheted unicorn. So it would be nice to see the difference. Okay, so again, our paste. And what I'm going to do is start to roll it out before I put it onto the mould. Oh, stuck to the table a bit there.
So, Donna Ryan, I can do the colours in sets, but because there's so many colours, I haven't put them in and I didn't want to scare you when you saw how much it was. Mm-hmm. But anybody who wants to message me about bundles or they want to buy so many, message me and I will answer you tomorrow. Not tonight, because I'm too busy putting stuff on the website.
Just don't go to bed.
I left this house at 6 o'clock this morning.
Oh dear.
Oh, and we need the same time tomorrow.
That's rolled in. I only need, you know, you don't need to get the whole piece of, you know, the whole knitted piece. You're just going to have a piece, you're going to cut it out. So hopefully that should be enough. Yeah, it will be. Okay, so we'll just turn it over and peel the mould away. And you see there, you've got your knitted pattern. So, I've got a cutting wheel. And checking the height, it's just slightly too big. So I'm just going to take off a little piece here. Okay. And then work out how much I need to wrap around so it just fits. And I'll just take off a little bit at the sides.
So all the colours are edible and they're safe for all diets and suitable for vegetarians and vegans and halal diets.
Now I've just got to stretch that. Seemed to fit before. Just stretch it slightly, it'll be fine. Okay, so I'm going to brush glue all over. Oh, one thing I did forget. I forgot little small scissors, but I'll use.
Got some scissors.
If you've got small, I can always use the dress cutter. It doesn't
small.
Matter. I just realised I forgot to cut out some little
these.
They'll do. Yeah, they'll do. This is okay for now. I might need these anyway later. Thank you. So I'm just going to cut out some little V's or triangles along the bottom, so it fits. The shape fits nicely around the body. So it's going to tuck under like this and then come up and wrap round, pulling together at the back. Now up here, scissors, and I'll cut off the height first of all. And then the piece at the back.
Do you want me to use this camera, John, to show me in close up?
No, it should be okay.
Is this one close enough?
No.
No.
Maria's filming that one.
Oh, right. So it's this one
yeah.
needs to see better.
Goes,
okay,
yeah.
So I've just trimmed the top.
And Maria as well.
And here.
You had a great beauty, you did that.
Oh. And then down the back. Now there, where you can see the sort of slight gap, what I'm going to do is just brush a little bit of glue onto the body and then pull over the paste using the Dresden tool to pull it over. Where my fingers have sort of squashed it, you just mark the knitted pattern back in. I can't see from here what
it's
I'm
okay.
doing. But you just basically follow the pattern as much as you can. I know I'm doing it wrong because I can't really see.
No, they understand that you're
yeah.
having to do it from the back to front.
Yeah, but like on the crochet one, the pattern is more random and it's
yeah.
quite easy there. But you see here, like you've got that smooth line. So if you just mark it like this, you hardly see it once it's all pushed in.
Is that good enough for you, John? Yeah.
yeah.
Can you see it sort of disappearing now?
Yeah. We've got two cameras right in your face there.
Not in my face,
God bless you.
No, we don't want close-ups anymore. No. So, yeah, I'm just pushing those over as much as I can. And it is quite bad because of the angle I'm at. I'll try and show you better on some of the others, the other figures later.
So guys, I can't shout out any questions because I'm now hanging over the side doing a close-up. I'm actually going to give this to Barry. So yeah, Barry, you can hang over the side.
So I'm just going to pick this up a second just to have a little look.
Yeah.
It's not too bad considering I couldn't really see what I was doing.
So Barry's on close-up camera, Maria's filming.
Okay. Yeah, so you just literally just emboss that pattern with your Dresden tool where you've sort of pressed it in. Okay. And then if I turn it round to the front there, you should hopefully still be able to see the knitted pattern. Okay. So now his legs. So I'm roughly making one leg shape, and I think that'll be about right. So I know now I need two pieces that size, two legs. So I roll back into a bowl and then check I get another piece the same size, roughly. So what you can do now is just roll them together. Roll a sausage and then cut the sausage in half so you know your legs should be the same size, excuse me. So now if I just pinch, point, make it fatter at the end. Same with this one. Point, flatten, make it thicker and flatten the hoof end. Okay, and then I'm going to roll the knit again for the piece to cover his legs.
It's not active.
Technical issues.
So a couple of people said it's hard to see the detail on the white, but it will all come together.
Yeah.
But don't worry. Yeah. Karen's already showed you the little beauty that she's going to make. So maybe if the next time this camera comes up on active, John can Barry can actually show us. So do you want to put it on active, John, and show Barry can show us what we're making? I'm going to show this one over here. Can you see it? Can you see it? Yeah. So this is what Karen is making at the moment. Yeah. So with the bright lights in here, it's a bit difficult in the close-up, but it will all come together. Don't worry. Just wait.
Right, I'm going to roll the paste into the mould again. If I use a big rolling pin like this, these side pieces mean that the paste you roll will only go to the same depth as the mould, as it is in the mould, okay? But if you use a rolling pin shorter, you can get the paste thinner if you want to.
Okay.
Or the other alternative, another thing you can do, is roll the paste out here before you put it in, just to make it easier, so you get it quite thin, and then use your smaller rolling pin. It's quite nice when you do these figures because, too much paste there, you see it's still too thick, because you're actually dressing a body, really, with it. So. You do want this to be quite thin, so that will probably do actually, and you can still go over it with your fingers a little bit, so that will be thinner than I used for the body. I just wanted to show you that you can have it so it is a little bit thinner. So each leg,
and which knitted mould is this one?
This is just the knit,
just the
knitted
knit.
Yeah, the knitted piece. So I want it straight along the bottom. Does make your eyes go a bit funny actually, looking when you're staring at it, drawing over the straight line. Now this, you can see, you're going to wrap this around. So I know I need about this. I can trim the top with the scissors later. If I turn that over, and this is going to wrap around the leg. So I need to cut it here and here. Oh, actually, what you can do, don't join it up. Like if I trim, I just leave a little gap because it can have a little gap at the back, you know, where it's sort of sitting. And now that, if I trim that, cut that straight up and brush glue on.
Geraldine's desperate for you to make that elephant.
The elephant, oh, I will shape the head and show you. I mean, they're pretty much.
The bodies are the same,
now. Yeah, pretty much all the same. Like, the only difference with the elephant.
Which way you sit the legs and arms.
Yeah, his legs that I'm, like, I'm making the unicorn's legs now that are actually at the bottom touching the cake. The elephant's legs are thicker at the top as well, the more a straight sausage sort of shape, rolling pin shape. So wrap that round.
So
So, Lisa Cheshire, we are using the Karen Davies sugar paste, and it's amazing. And it's amazing for models. It's not. It's got Tylo in it, so you can use it for covering your cakes. But it's absolutely amazing for your models. You don't need to add anything else, and they work. And it works beautifully in Karen's molds as well. And it tastes amazing. Two flavours, marshmallow and vanilla. Marshmallow being my favourite.
Everybody's favourite.
It's amazing, that flavour.
Yeah, so thin glue and then wrap around again. As long as those that bottom piece sort of meets there, fold it up and then trim.
Are you back. Going to the US this year, Karen, to do any shows?
No.
No.
No. Unfortunately.
Who's going to be stocking your moulds in the US?
Global Sugar Art do.
Yeah.
Craftsy.
Craftsy, yeah.
They haven't got them yet. There are a few others.
They haven't got them yet though, have they?
Yeah, Global have.
Global's got
them, I don't think they've got the new ones yet.
Yeah.
But they will have soon. Oh yeah. Yes, they have.
Have they gone off yet?
I think they've probably just got them in. Yeah, it gets very confusing with who's...
So anybody who's in America, if you want to order the moulds, nip over to Global Sugar Art. Let Alan know that we pointed you in his direction. He does buy our nifty nozzles off us.
Right, I need to roll another piece now for the... It's funny, it's four legs, isn't it? Unicorn's got four legs, but I call them his arms.
Yeah.
Not really, are they? But it just helps to describe...
Barry's got a bad back now, he now knows how John feels. Do you remember those days, John?
Trying to erase them from my memory.
I'm just putting a bit of cornflour on the back there as well.
This one closer, John. This one would be better if we could get this closer.
No, it's fine. Yeah.
But it's quite high up.
Can I?
Right. Here we go again. It's rolled nice and thin.
Great, Ray's open out again. Yeah, that's good.
So it's very thin for his arms.
You could leave it sat down then, Ray, would it?
And then just pull that away. Okay, and then we're going to... Now this time his legs or arms are down the front of his body.
So do you sell your moulds in Australia? Because we have Trish Cooper who follows us on here. She's here in the UK, but she's going to Australia soon. Who sells in Australia for you?
We did actually today have a new supplier, a new customer wanting to stock them. So I can't remember the name offhand, but I can let you know.
Yeah,
to let you know. Okay. I think...
Thank you, Donna. Donna Ryan is a very loyal customer to us at Sugar and Crumbs.
Oh.
And she's from the USA and she always orders off us.
That's nice.
And she goes, no, I'm in the US, but I'm still going to order from you.
Oh.
So thank you, Donna. We appreciate it.
Oh.
Bless her. The shipping costs her a fortune, but she does.
So you see there now, these legs, or as I call them, the arms, are going to be here.
All the moulds are on the website. I'm just missing one or two of them. Karen surprised me with a couple of extras that I didn't have on the website. So all the brand new moulds are on the website. The knitted piece that she's using now is on the website, okay? John, your mum's joined us. Hello, Dorothy. And this particular mould that Karen's using now is the knitted piece. She's also done this unicorn with the new mould, the crochet piece. The crochet, what's it called? The crochet?
Yes, crochet piece. There's knitted piece, crochet piece. Now really, they should both fit the same, shouldn't they?
All the moulds are on our website. And when this live feed finishes tonight, all the links to everything that we're selling tonight is attached to the live feed. And if you're on YouTube, they're all attached to YouTube as well. YouTube, it'll be on tomorrow afternoon.
So thin glue over both and wrap around. I just need to trim. You can see there that it's slightly too big at the top, so we just get the scissors and thin it out like that. And then the same with this one. I think things that models are always easier when you're shown, aren't they? And again, just trim away.
And you make it look so easy, Karen.
And there's his front legs.
So what Karen's making here, she's making the unicorn. But what she's done is done the model and then she's actually covering it with the knitted piece. But you could use the crochet. What else could you use for it, Karen? Is the chunky knit too big for it?
It probably is. It is, yeah. Yeah, it's too thick, yeah. That one. Unless your toy is very, very big.
Yeah.
Or it was a novelty cake, you know, a novelty. You use sponges to do the body shape and everything.
Just to let you know, it's 9:06.
Gosh.
And considering we've got 100 things to show them, we're going to have to speed up.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm just speeding Karen up a bit.
Yeah. Right, so there again, get your Dresden tool and you can just blend in the join with your Dresden tool. Okay. Like that. And then the head. Now again, remembering that the head will be bigger when it's covered. So I think that probably looks about the right size. So if I take some off, that should work in theory. It should work. We shall see. You automatically go, you're trying to make everything smooth and neat. And, you know, I can do that as his head, because I'm going to cover it, can't I?
Cover it, absolutely, yeah.
So I tend to sort of, don't just do a ball. Obviously roll it into a ball first and then shape it a little bit so it's thinner. Where his eyes and his ears are going to be. Okay, so it's sort of that shape.
Maria's doing so well, bless her. You're really good, you, Maria, aren't you?
I'm trying to keep it. I think she's done this before.
The meadow mould. So somebody's asking, have you done the meadow mould? You did some bits on it, aren't you?
Yes.
Are you going to do any grass?
Yes, yeah. If Carol will
just
let me.
Just wait. She's going to do everything. She's only got 45 minutes left.
Oh, it's fine. Oh, that's fine. Loads of time. Loads of time. Okay, so I'm going to just roll this out now. This is the last piece I have to mould, the last knitted piece to mould. So pop that in there.
Richard Crompton says, time's never been a problem. You keep doing it. And he'll keep ordering. Richard and his wife both watch every week.
Oh, that's nice. Awesome. Yeah. Right, now this, with it being a different shape, you're going to have to sort of cut chunks away so it fits around. So it will go over.
The meadow mould has been on, but Karen's coming back to it, so don't worry.
This is the front of the head. So if I just put the glue on first, lay it right in the middle. It's going to wrap around to here. So if I do these two edges straight, these two sides, nice and straight.
Lynn Bond says she thought unicorns were girls. You keep calling them a he.
I'm sorry. Well, I don't know.
I think there's going to be boy unicorns as well, isn't there?
Yeah.
Boys and girls.
So.
In fact, we won't be able to say boys and girls soon. We'll have to say, let somebody decide. What are you saying?
Right, now this, I'm going to cut round the top here. I'm so hot, I feel like I'm melting the sugar paste now. So if I just press it together there, and then trim.
So Karen Mayer has just popped on and said she made rabbit moles last week from Patchwork Cutters, and she appreciates all you demonstrators coming on and giving them the confidence to give it a go.
Aww.
In fairness, I saw Karen put a post up that if she hadn't been watching our lives, she wouldn't have tried half the things that she's tried.
That's nice.
Yeah.
So you see, I've just cut around the edge, so you've got the shape, and you can hardly see the joins, really. And he's going to have his ears here, and his horn. His. There we go. His. I just automatically... Her.
Well, you can't change now.
No. Well, these days you can.
They probably can these days.
Yeah. This is whatever it wants to be. It's fine.
It's in his own. Yeah, whatever you want it to be. It hasn't decided.
Yeah.
You know they have to decide themselves.
Right, so we've done little knitted marks again there. Okay. Now, I forgot to bring with me, I make little sticks out of flour paste and...
Do you want some cocktail sticks?
I've got some. Right. Yeah, I shouldn't put a cocktail stick in because this is for, obviously, it's for Carol. So if it was for a child, you would not do this, okay?
So just show what you do with me.
Yeah, I like, say this is flour paste, I just make...
I saw you do this trick, it was quite cool.
Yeah, this is wrong, but it's too soft. But if you make flour paste sticks like this and let them dry, okay, they will dry really hard.
Yeah.
So you can push it into the body and the head and you've got a really good support that's edible.
Yeah.
And as the unicorn dries, this will soften up again. So it's not going to be something hard that's going to damage a child that decides to eat the unicorn. So
no one's eating this one. This is going to stay pride of place.
This is yours
on our shelf at the back.
What I'm going to do, instead of me taking the head now and pushing onto there, I'm going to make a hole with another cocktail stick, but first of all, I mark where it's going to go, then put the stick in and just twist and push. It doesn't matter if it comes out the top of the head, because that's where it's going to have its... Is it called a horn? Or the, it's probably got a fancy name as well.
That's a horn.
So the head go on. He's a taller unicorn. I'm going to just push him down a little bit.
Margaret Baldry's just joined us and says she hopes Karen is feeling better. She's still poorly, so she's still got the sniffles, but she's with us. The show must go on.
Yeah, it's not too bad now. It's a lot better. The only other thing I've forgotten is my mouth tool, the little smiley mouth tool. So I'm just going to mark a little smiley mouth with this Dresden tool. Usually I use like the little, the black gem tool.
Yeah.
But that'd be okay. Okay.
Right. Did you show that to the audience? Oh, sorry, Maria's the audience. She's got the cameras both on.
Oh, yes, both on point in the
Point to Maria now. Maria's filming. Do you want to just show what you did there?
Okay, just the Dresden tool, just to mark in the mouth. Okay. I think he's solid. I'm just worried about the head.
He's going to look beautiful, don't worry.
Stay.
Oh, Gillian, that is so naughty. Gillian says, call it Carol, she's great at making horns. I had to make a unicorn one last year. I'm glad the show was after 9.
Oh dear.
It was getting all out of hand.
Oh dear.
And I couldn't stop giggling.
Well, anyway, this is what you do for this one. Okay, ball of paste, start to roll it. And if you keep it thin at both ends, fat in the middle, okay? Fold it in half in the middle and twist like that, okay? Now if you use flour paste, it will dry quicker because that's probably too soft for me to paint at the moment. I'm going to cut off the end at the bottom so it's flat. So when I glue that on, it's easier.
So, Loops, yes, you can watch it on Facebook. When this live finishes, it will be pinned to our page, and you'll be able to watch it on YouTube tomorrow afternoon. And Maria is in the background, and Maria does close-ups, and she'll be making lots of one-minute videos this week. It looks like Maria's going to be here till 1 in the morning, catching up with Karen.
Oh, dear. So, the ears, just a little ball of paste. Pinch, point at the top, flatten, okay, and you've got your nice ear shapes there, and then you can put a little piece of pink in as well, so tiny bit of glue, and somewhere, hopefully, I've got some, lilac, it's going to have lilac inside its ears, I've brought pink, I've got a dark pink, do. I'll mix it with some white actually. Look better. Okay. So this time a smaller bowl of paste for each ear. Rubbing away. So again the same point, pinch to flatten. Put it onto there. Same again. Point, flatten. Put it onto the ear. I feel like my hands have gone like that. I'm trying to do little fiddly things now. And then the end of this rolling pin. This is a cell pin, but you can use a ball tool. Just press them in like that, and then put some glue to the head. Attach the ears. And just press it in with the smaller end. Okay, and then we've got some black for the eyes. I made small little indents with the bone tool or ball tool there, so just put a little bit of glue or water in, and then some black for the eyes. And what I do, I think they look too small, keep rolling the balls of paste till they look the same size, which sounds daft. Sometimes I end up with about, no, they look okay, I end up with about 5 for 2 eyes, so drop them in. And then take the ball tool again and just flatten them out. You can actually, if one looks bigger than the other, you can sort of stretch them, you know, just rub them a little bit, stretch them. And then to make the mane, you need to roll lots of coloured paste. So you just start with a little ball and pinch. There's lots of different ways to do the mane, like this. And then just sort of twist. And make all these little shapes to attach. So you need to do them in lots of different colours. So I've done the colours to match these stripes around the side of the cake. And I also use these for his tail at the back. So I'll just attach a few. When you attach pieces of paste, like these are dry. So if the unicorn was dry and these pieces were dry, you would need to use royal icing. But because this is still soft, the paste is still nice and soft, you can use glue, edible glue. Now that's glue made with Tylo CMC powder. It's a bit low down actually. So you can just start to press these in at whatever angle you want. One. Got very quiet.
I know, everybody's engrossed. The world's saying that. The world's engrossed watching him.
Oh. So he seems to start to build it up like
and
this.
And they're not saying anything because they've all swiped to the left or the right or doing the okie cokie, whatever they're doing. They can't place any comments now.
Oh. I'm just putting a few little pieces in the tail there just so you get the idea that it's going to be down there as well. It's quite
He's
good.
Looking fabulous.
Yeah, it's good that it's still soft and you can push the...
Don't go mingy on the air because it's mine.
Oh, I'll put as many as I can in, Carol. I might have to stay late later and finish him.
Finish him off later, yeah. I'll make you a coffee.
There are some more pieces in here, but...
They're all loving it. Isn't he so beautiful? Or she?
She. She's a she. We've established it's a she now. That's it. It's a she forever. Okay, so it needs lots of these, obviously, putting down the back. So I'm going to leave them all on the board and try and put them in later. I wish I'd brought some flower paste now to make some to dry, but there's quite a few there. So what I'm going to do next
Don't
is
worry, I can make some.
A pair of crochet booties, which are very, very easy to do. Okay, now... We have got a pattern for the booties, but what I will do is email it to Carol tomorrow. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot, just realised the unicorn needs his feet painting gold.
Yeah.
Okay, that's sure. The other thing as well.
Yeah.
So you can see on the, we'll bring the main cake in maybe at the end to show you.
Do you want to drop that cake down?
Oh, he's finished, I'll do it now. Yeah. Which way am I going now? Who's going?
John, which camera are we on?
Go.
There you are, can you see it?
Twirling round. So you can see that mane.
It's not active,
pin.
Is it?
Turn there.
John's not made it cat active yet. Just 1 second. Maria's going to help out. So guys, give us the thumbs up. What do you think, okay? So Karen's finished this one on the top of the cake, and she cannot finish the one that we're doing because we need to move on. She needs to paint, needs to do other things to it. But at the moment, so can you see this beautiful rib cable? What's it called?
Cable knit. Yeah, rustic cable.
So John, are we on there? Because
Okay.
So everyone, give us a thumbs up. What do you think? Isn't it beautiful? And the knit that's on the actual cake is the rustic cable knit. And then she's made the unicorn. So the one that she's made live tonight, she's used the knitted piece. And the one that's on this cake that she's done is the new crochet mold. Fabulous. So we love it.
Oh, great.
Right, so what are we on to next then, Karen?
Right, now I'm going to do some crochet booties.
Crochet booties?
Yes.
Pretty good. Alright, plenty of babies going to go on this year.
Not more grandchildren, is it?
I've got another one due in June. My eighth. Yeah. John and I are on alert from running down to London. We're wondering how to fit in a full-time job. Grandchildren up here, run down to London, make sure we see that baby off to another. Plus get to Ireland to see John's nieces as well.
Oh gosh.
So
Busy.
Yeah.
Right, okay. So, what I'm going to do first...
They love it, Karen. Absolutely love it.
Good.
Good.
Excuse me. Is cut out the soles for the booties. So, we roll out some paste again into the crochet piece. Let's go across. I want the soles to be not thick, but the thickness of the mould. I'm not trying to make it thinner or anything. This time with the small rolling pin, I want it a bit thicker. So there's a template for the sole of the shoe, which I haven't got with me. I'm just going to cut out roughly the shape, so you'll see the shape.
So the template Karen's going to send over to me, and tomorrow I'll actually put it in the product details of the crochet mold. So if you want to look for it, I'll actually put the template inside the product details. This is a beautiful mold. Who thought of these ones to do then?
I did. About 5 years ago.
Yeah.
When we first brought them out. So you see that's one shoe there. That's the left foot. It's not very good actually. I'm just thinking the big toe looks like it's here actually. So I'll say that's the right foot.
Do you see the same? Not left or right.
Saying nothing. No, because I want the opposite shape, I'll turn it over that way now. Okay, so when you get your pattern for the shoes, you only need one, and you just turn it over.
So, quick question.
Yeah.
Carol Hawker says, what mould did you use to get the edge on the top of the top and bottom of the chunky cable?
Right, that is, I've got to show the chunky cable knit mould.
Comes in one mould.
Yes, this is the top edge here.
Yeah.
This piece here. Okay, and these are the cables that I've used around the unicorn cake.
And you've got all those buttons as well, haven't you?
There's a fluffy bobble, a little heart, a toggle that's called.
Can you see that toggle?
Yeah. This one.
That one? Yep. This one. Another knitted.
This is the one here, John.
No, back of it.
Yeah,
that one. Perfect.
Right, so for the top and bottom of the cake, she's used these moulds here.
And the chunky cable comes in two sizes, mm-hmm. and you've got buttons, you've got bubbles, you've got the edging for the top of your cake. There's a hell of a lot in this mould. It's yes. absolutely beautiful. It's one of my favourite moulds.
Yeah, I do use that one on a lot of things. Alice designed beautiful. That one. So, we're nearly at the end of this. There we go. So we've got the two soles for the shoes there, I think. Which is left, which is right. Okay, so now I'm going to do the front of the shoe. There's so many different ways to do these. I think on the worksheet we've got, I think we might have a few different instructions for different things. You can also use on this for the front of the shoe, you can use the crochet bow. Maybe I'll do two different shoes instead of doing just the one on top of the cake.
26 minutes past 9. I've got 4 minutes. We might be going for a 3-hour session tonight.
No. These are quick. Honestly, I promise we will be done by 9:45 the latest.
Karen, did you bring that all tonight?
Yes.
Good. I feel as though I may as well not go to bed tonight.
Oh dear. So take the excess paste off. Here.
So all the moulds are on our website, and the ones that you don't see, I will be staying up all night and adding them to it. Karen's brought stock.
Look at that, slippers, little slippers. They're not, you know, they can even be on a lady's cake, can't they? They could be little slippers.
Yeah,
so all you do there is just put your glue. That's why you want the sole to be a little bit thicker. So you've got something to attach the top to. I'm actually just going to give that a little tiny pull, little tiny stretch. Okay. And when you're pressing on, it, rather than using your fingers or your thumbs, press with the Dresden tool.
Yeah.
Because that will give it a much better join.
By the way, guys, if you haven't got these tools, we do sell them as sets. There's two sets on the website, full sets of tools, or you can buy them individually via the PME or FMM. If you look at those brands on our website. But otherwise, you can buy them as sets in the Sugarcraft accessories section.
Right, so now I'm going to do the other shoe, the front of the other shoe. So if I just roll that in, take out, and this time I'm going to do the same shoe as on the front of the cake here.
Jane's store, his battery's running out.
Oh dear.
Go and get it plugged in, Jane.
So I want this to lift up. So if you imagine here, I'm cutting round, meeting at the front of the shoe and then out at the side, a little bit bigger. Probably a bit too much there. Just go up a bit. And then across, pull out there. We'll see what that's like. And then again with your glue around the front of the front edge of the shoe, booty, whatever. And then this piece you fit around the front. And then push in again like before. So you've got your front of your shoe. Then we want a strip round the back.
Lesna says she's already got all of your moulds. I hope you may have a cardiac when the new moulds arrive.
Does she know what time the postman arrives so she can hide them?
Nesma's having a baby soon in June as well.
Aww. So that's the shape for the back. We'll just need to round that a little bit. I'm just trying to do it very quickly. Really, it's not the most perfect shape. I should have rolled it out and cut it again. But I'm just going to put the glue around the back. And you see, I don't even have to support it with anything. If you were, you know, because it's such a firm paste, it's holding its shape. So I'll put that around the back like that.
It's a beautiful paste.
And then, again, press in with the Dresden tool so you don't lose the pattern.
Elaine Lawton says you make it look so easy. All the ladies are saying how much trouble they're going to be. You know what to say to your husband, you've had it for ages.
That's probably a little bit short, but I'm going to cheat and just stretch it a little bit. I'm just trying to be as quick as I possibly can. Glue again. And then over. Right, just need to push that back up. Press it on with the Dresden tool and same there. Because that's so little and thin, it is slipping a little bit. So we could just put a little bit of paper.
Carol says she gets all hers sent to work so she can smuggle them home. Jane Allen wants us to provide a lightweight lifter to help her carry them all over.
I'm going to roll a piece for this because I think I just need a bit bigger for the strap.
Gillian says, I always say, yeah, where did that come from? She's digging it out the cupboard. Mm-hmm. We all have our ways, ladies. Believe me, these guys have just as much. They just keep a lot more stum about it.
So this time I'm making the piece along the top of the shoe, over the top. So it's a strap.
Jane says, I'm better off having no husband. I live alone. Sorry, John. Aww. Don't worry, Jane. John would love to live alone.
Right, so I'm just putting a little bit of glue under here.
He's not getting away though. He has to do Facebook Live twice a week.
Aww. It's got to go under the front of the shoe. And then I'm press it on with the Dresden tool there like that, so it's secure. And then it'll go over. It's too long. So just cut a piece off. And then the glue again. Under there. Press in.
Lynn Risby, you're going to have to catch up. You've missed an hour and a half. I can't tell you what we've done. So you'll have to watch playback later. We'll pop over to YouTube tomorrow. Sarah says, Carol, good point. Hubbies get far more deliveries.
Not this house.
I was going to say, John doesn't. Hey, listen, how much do you spend on your bike, Barry Davies?
You don't
want I'll just have a chat with John on how many bottles of wine he buys each week.
All the secrets are coming out now. I've just folded up a little bit of kitchen paper there just to support it, probably till the morning, you know, just to make sure it's really dry. I've put a little button. This is the button mould. We've got the button mould and the baby button mould, which, oh, here it is, which has got some very tiny novelty buttons on.
They're so cute, those
okay.
little shoes.
So, yeah, so you can choose whatever you want. I'm going to put a little flower on this one, I think. I just put a little bit of paste in, take off the excess.
Is it daughter? Amy. Amy's watching. Hello, Mum.
Is she better?
How's she going?
She wasn't feeling well today. Hopefully she's better.
Has she got what you've got?
Maybe.
Amy Lee's joined us, Karen's daughter. She's meant to be in bed. But then again, she can watch the live though, can't she? If she's in bed, she's resting.
Yeah, that's true. So I'm going back to the cable knit now, you know, to the fluffy bobble I've got here. I don't want it that size, so I'm just going to put in a small piece.
So Abigail says, little tip, if you have a shoe template on paper, which Karen's going to send us tomorrow, you can scan it and you can make it bigger or smaller for different size cakes.
Yeah.
Well done, Anne.
Yeah. So I'm just going to put this, I've made it a little bit smaller.
Joyce says that she tells her husband, at least I don't spend it all at the pub, and I've now got four sets of shelves, boxes full of moulds. He must spend a lot at the pub.
So that
must be a friend of John's.
Oh, that you could do the button and the bobble in white, okay, to make it stand out. I'm just going to put a little bit more kitchen paper underneath that bit there to hold the strap up till the morning, okay? It's just slightly stuck.
Amy says Jordan's got it now. She's off to bed.
Oh,
and
no.
Got it then.
Oh no. That's a problem when you've got children, isn't it? You just, everything goes round everybody.
Yeah.
Oh dear. Oh. Okay, so there's the little shoe for a little girl, and the little slipper. Okay. So that's everything, isn't it, I think?
Yeah.
Have I got time to go back to the grass?
Yeah, you have. You need to go back to the grass. They might kill me if I don't let you do this grass. So we're going to go back to the wild meadow mould. And then what we're going to do is show you all these amazing cakes that Karen's made with her new moulds. We'll go through them all again for you. So she's going to quickly show you how to make the grass.
Green
she's made some flowers.
Right, I haven't got quite enough to do the whole big piece. Okay, so I'll just do what I can. So I'll just soften this up so it's easier to roll in.
Can we see the shoe on the cake?
Oh, can you see the shoe on the cake? Yeah,
I'll get that next.
When she's done this, we're going to get all the cakes down again, like we did at the front, at the beginning. We'll get all the cakes down and show you them all again.
Okay.
Joe Fitchett, you know what, you're so right. Moulds are much cheaper than golf clubs. There you go, John. Yes, what about golf? John has that as a hobby as well.
Oh, dear. Oh. Right, okay. So,
and football tickets.
So obviously, if I was doing the whole depth of the mould, this would be a bigger piece. You just start to roll it in. Now, the grass at the top, when you push... You sort of push up into the grass, but then rub it down as well in between. So you see sort of cleaning up the edge.
Dawn Butler's just joined us.
Oh, hello, Dawn.
Hi, Dawn.
So push that in and roll along. Push up and then pull down. And because it's so sort of irregular, you don't really notice if you don't get them all, or, you know, they're not all in properly, or they're going over the edge a little bit. You don't really notice.
So Carol's asking, what's best to colour the sugar paste? You can use any colour, any colour brand that you like. It has to be your own personal favourite. Here at Sugar and Crumbs, we use the Colour Splash gels, which I absolutely love. And we've just brought out a new range of colour gels. The images are not on the website yet because we're still finishing them. They'll be on by tomorrow night. But I will show them you at the end when we finish.
Yeah, the basic rule is paste or gel into sugar paste.
Yes.
Powders are to brush or paint on.
That's a good point, yeah. Use gels for your sugar paste, powders for dusting.
So that, you just turn it over and it will just fall out, okay? So I'll just straighten up.
Linda Miles tells her husband, I don't drink, I don't smoke, but I can always start and it'll cost a lot more.
Okay, and then quickly showing you the colour, if you want to put some colour on, use the flat brush, and if you go in between with that flat brush, you see the difference it makes, bringing out the detail. Again, you can use a dark, you know, this is a slightly darker green, and then you can go over the top pieces with a light to paler green. And I like to brush with a bigger brush than this really as well, go across a little bit just to catch the detail on there. Okay, so that's it, very basic. And on the wild meadow cake, Alice has put like two layers on. So you see that stands up quite well on its own. You might have to sport it a little bit, but you can see there that it's really strong and sturdy. Mm. And then she's put a shorter layer in front
we're
as well.
Yeah.
You can also, I have got a knife here. I just mind your wooden worktop. But you can chop into it a little bit as well if you want to. You know, just get finer blades.
Yeah.
And when you do that, I think it looks quite nice if you pull some forward.
And I don't like it.
Yes, he agreed.
He loves grass.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, so that's a really useful one, isn't it? Okay, so shall I just show all the cakes again?
Yes.
Quickly to
finish
off. Starting with the
cakes. Do you want to go to the meadow one? Because you've just been on there talking to them about that. So Karen is just going to show you all the cakes again. So this cake here, she's going to tell you which moulds that she's used. So for all of you who want to know, so this is her brand new mould, and it's the Wild Meadow mould. It's, how much is it, John?
$17.99.
She's used a butterfly mould as well, which is not on our website, but it will be tonight.
Yeah, that's it. You see the two, I was just talking about the two layers of grass.
Yeah.
The different heights, which I think looks really nice.
Yeah, I think it looks beautiful. I think it looks very, very effective.
Yeah, yeah. And the cake's just been airbrushed a little bit.
Yeah.
And a few sort of my bad painting trees and grasses around.
I think it looks absolutely
It's just
gorgeous,
really, the painting. Absolutely. The trees, it's just a sort of, it's an illusion.
I just think it just looks so effective, it really does. So this is the wild meadow mold. So then if you go over to the chunky...
Chunky rib with the booties, because somebody wanted to see the booties close up.
So this is the chunky rib. This is new on the website, that brand new mold. And I think it's £16.50, isn't it? Have you got the mold to show them?
Mm-hmm.
Because you can do those.
Yeah.
You can do those nice laces on the front, can't you?
Yeah, I haven't actually demonstrated this mould, but you just use it exactly the same way as I did the knitted piece and the crochet piece. And sometimes with these moulds, when you roll the paste in, if you're having any difficulty, try rolling it the opposite way. So instead of side to side that way, do it top to bottom or whatever and try. And you'll find one way is easier than the
other. Let me just have a look at that mould there. So with that mould on this cake, you've used the chunky cable
to do
the edges and the bubbles. The where is that chunky cable? So it is good to buy both of those.
That's the rib. That's this piece here.
And then
the little bobble there was this. I put a smaller piece in, but I put a ball of paste on first and then lay it over the
top. And you've got big bubbles on the bottom here with your blue
To match.
Your tie, which is fantastic.
There.
So that chunky cable is really very, very good. Okay, and then if we pull over the crochet one, Karen?
Yeah, that's got the same trim around the top of the ornate.
All these chunky knit, they look great if you buy the chunky cable with it for finishing off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah, it's got all these little useful things with it. We do use this a lot around the tops and bottoms of the cakes, and I've used the smaller cable. On the bottom there, and the buttons, lots of buttons on that one. The buttons are good actually for hiding the joins, you only join the pieces together.
Well,
and I didn't mention that before, when I did the animals, when you join the pieces together, if you make sure they're really close, really squashed up close together, and then use your Dresden tool to try and disguise the join, it really helps.
Is that a view there? Okay. Okay, so then we're going to go over to the chunky cable. Josh is going to get ready
There's the cable again, all the coloured cables.
So this is one of my... I love all these chunky knit molds. But you know, I don't know whether I love that because of all the colours.
Mm.
And I love it because you can do them separately as well. So, you know, they're brilliant.
Yeah, this was so easy. When I was actually making this cake, there was so much happening that day. I actually got Sarah, who works with us, to help me because she decorates cakes at Christmas. She's a very good baker, isn't she? She brings in lovely things sometimes for us to eat. And she doesn't decorate cakes very often, but it was no trouble. She just knocked these out really quickly because they're so easy.
And then we've got the unicorn there on that top of that cake. John, are we back on this camera? On this cake?
I didn't quite finish painting him, did I? So you've got a nice gold. I saw a lovely soft gold in your colours you've got. And I just paint. I don't put anything extra on for his hooves. I just paint them.
Yeah.
And the little horn there. And then you can see the finished mane. See how big it is there.
Me and Maria finished this one. That you didn't finish.
Okay. And then I'll finally get the rabbits and the elephant.
Do you want to show this one?
Mm-hmm.
Can you get it?
Yeah, manage.
Yeah, super. Got friends on the front. So guys, give Karen some round of applause. All these love hearts, everything.
Oh.
Let her know how much you appreciate everything she's done.
So this one
is the chunky knit.
The chunky knit.
Got it right.
Yes. because this on the rabbit, on the bunny, it's the knitted piece.
The knitted piece.
You can see it's the same pattern.
But
it's
finer.
Just big. Yeah, that's finer. And this is big, so it's chunky. So it's a chunky knit. And again, there's the border off the cable knit.
Yeah. So you definitely need that cable knit.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, you need all these moles. They're just great. You know what I love about the moles, being able to use them?
Yeah.
Your cake doesn't have to be that smooth.
No.
You can hide a million things, doesn't it?
Well, these.
Like when you're doing smooth sugar paste over it and you're worrying about sharp edges and everything. It just disguises the whole mole.
I know. Well, the reason we did develop these a few years ago, all these side designs, was so you could just cover the top of your cake.
Yeah.
We use your buttercream or whatever, just do a nice flat top of your cake with your sugar paste, and then use these as the side covering.
Yeah.
So it makes it so easy, you know.
Yeah. And I'll tell you that when I go live demo them, Karen.
Yeah. It will be.
It's on my list to do.
It will. So this is the patchwork squares, which again Carol is going to have in about 2 days' time, ready to send out.
It's the only mold she didn't bring over tonight.
Yeah. Oh. So it's just had some squares cut out and different colours put in.
I am going to put it on the website tonight, but it just means anybody who orders this one, your order's just going to be delayed by 2 days.
And the elephant, I did say at the beginning, the elephant's head, you do need to model the day before, so the trunk stays in position. Super. And he's got a little toy
such
elephant
a good
there,
idea to just
the button mold, baby buttons.
So it's such a good idea to cover the mould with your moulds, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And the two cakes behind
you. Oh, forgot. Yes,
don't forget those.
Yeah, last one, Joe, not least. We've got the Easter cake. That's got the bark. Oh, and I think you do have those.
Yes, I do. We've got
the
bark.
I forgot to bring extra of those, but I think you might have them.
So all these we have, and I take it you've used your wild meadow there.
Yes.
Go on, so explain that.
Yeah, on... this is the buttercream flowers. But I've tried to make them look like daffodils, rose daffodils.
Well, everybody must have that buttercream flowers.
Yeah, it's this flower here, these little blossoms.
Yeah.
So you just use yellow paste and then brush the centres with orange.
Yeah. And then you've used the wild meadow all around the bottom here.
Yes, all over
the wild meadow.
Yeah, the little bunny, just see the bunny disappearing down there. So I've just used like an arch of flowers.
Yeah.
Over the top.
And for the grass as well, that's the wild meadow as well, isn't
it? This is the top of the wild meadow, the top edge. But the other little bits of grass here, I've just pushed paste through a sieve.
Yeah.
Okay.
Super. They're beautiful.
And the grass effect is with a scrubbing brush.
Super.
A clean scrubbing brush.
Don't forget your teapot.
A teapot. Christina's teapot.
So Christina Ludlum did this one.
So
absolutely
lovely.
Beautiful.
She has such good ideas.
She does, doesn't she?
Really good. Really She's good. Got really good... And she's really good, you know, imagining how to design these sort of things. It's lovely.
I'm doing a class with her in May, so 2 day class.
Yeah. Oh, good.
That's beautiful.
It's
isn't
lovely,
it?
Isn't it? It's got our crochet flowers and buttons on there. Look, she's made the Battenberg by hand.
Yeah. And that's the crochet mold, the chunky crochet mold. That's what
just,
that is.
Yeah, just crochet, the crochet.
Yeah. Super.
That's it.
Right. Okay then.
That's everything.
Yeah. Super. So let me just come back around here. With my little tray.
Oh, your colours.
I know, all my colours. So, guys, give Karen a big round of applause. Get those thumbs up. Love hearts. Please let Karen know. Come over here, Karen. Please let her know how much you appreciate. A lot of hard work goes in, and we try to show you as much as we can in 2 hours. And we know 2 hours is a really long session, but you can see yourself when you're watching. We do have to speed things up and take a couple of shortcuts, but we work really very, very hard, okay? So please let Karen and Barry know that you appreciate them coming over. All the molds are on our website, www.sugarandcrumbs.co.uk. Just drop down to brands, which you'll find Karen Davies, and Maria has actually put all the links on as well. And this is a new range of colours. Now, they're not all on the website, okay? I got to be honest, I spoke to this gentleman last week, I tested them last week, and they all got delivered today. And me and Laura in the office, have been frantically trying to get them on. So they're listed, but they haven't all got their images on, okay? Now, there's a beautiful range. These are all the dusts. There's loads of them. These are all beautiful dusts. They're all edible. They're all for all dietary. So if you're vegetarian, vegan, if you've got halal, you can add these on. The same with the gels. The gels are bigger. They're in 30 grams. They are more expensive than the Colour Splash range, but these are all edible. Well, to be fair, the Colour Splash range is all edible as well. I'm not taking it away from this Colour Splash range, but some colours are not suitable for vegetarians and vegans.
These pens, look at these pens are absolutely gorgeous. If you're going to use these pens on the sugar paste, wait till your sugar paste has dried, okay? That's got a really fine nib and it writes beautifully. Okay, so there's all those colours there. Like I say, the pictures will be on tomorrow and all the content will be on tomorrow. These airbrushing gels, and I see Karen's got her eye on these, I might let her have a couple. Okay, look at these for colours. How amazing are they, these? These are your airbrush colours. Look at those. They're absolutely stunning. I just love that one. Look, look at that gorgeous red. So these are not on the website, but they will be on tomorrow, by tomorrow night. Laura and I are working as fast as we can. Tonight I'm going to get the rest of Karen Davies' moulds on, what we're missing. But we are going to get them on. Can you use them for eyes? So Karen's just used the pen there.
I've
on
just
the...
put pink. It's probably too deep, really. But
yeah.
It's
lovely, yeah. It's just have it go. Yeah. You could probably colour in that yellow in the centre there. So all these are on the website. Maybe all the images and the content is not there, but by tomorrow night they will be. If anybody wants to buy these as a set, they are quite expensive as a set, but if you private message me, I'm sure I can do you a discount along the way. That's beautiful colour,
gorgeous,
isn't it? Yeah, they are absolutely stunning and I'm so excited to actually have them. I don't actually know anybody else here in the UK who stocked them,
I've never seen light airbrush colours like
No,
this.
Neither have I. Yeah. So we're very lucky, I believe, to have them. So I'll have them all finished by tomorrow night. And then what else was I going to show you? I was actually going to show you, I think these, I'll bother, they're there. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, so this is the last session now for Easter on a Monday night. We're not here next Monday because it's Bank Holiday Monday. I am here on Thursday morning. I've got Jackie Heaton, the Bacon Nana, and Rob Allen coming down. And poor Rob missed it last time because of the snow. And guess what? We've been told we're having snow on Thursday. So can you believe it? He's coming down. All the weather's cleared up and apparently we're getting snow again on Thursday. But I believe he's coming down Wednesday night. So on Thursday, 11 o'clock, it's our baking session. So Jackie Heaton, the Bacon Nana, Rob Allen will be here. They are making a cheesecake, an Easter cheesecake with our velvet vanilla. We're making a Black Forest gatto and we're making like these Viennese finger things. I can't remember what they're called, but I know. Do you know those ones that melt in your mouth? There's Viennese swirls,
yes,
aren't they?
Yeah.
And then
they've
one end dipped in chocolate. Yes. They're amazing. I just love them. Look, Maria's doing backflips already. So 11 o'clock, okay? So we're here 11 o'clock on Thursday. We're not here on Monday, but we're back the following Thursday and we'll continue. So thank you for joining us. Please like and share. It's very important you like and share. If you're on YouTube, please subscribe. It costs nothing to subscribe. You may have to make yourself another email address, a Gmail address, but it's free. And it really helps us if you get those thumbs up and send us your comments. And we'd really like to up our Facebook reviews, so feel free to jump on there and put our reviews up, like our page. Don't forget to like Karen's page as well. And my last cheeky request is, if you can nip over to Google and just Google sugar and crumbs, scroll down and it'll ask you if you would like to write a review. So wherever you can write a review about us, please do. We are only a small company, we are growing, you know, we're only a team of seven. So we've got five employees and me and John and we do everything. So we really, really need your support. Be very, very grateful.
It's great you're doing all this for everybody.
I know, you said that before, didn't you?
It's amazing.
And Karen was saying before, she can't believe that we give up every Monday and Thursday to do this. It is a lot of hard work, and I know so many of you appreciate it. But anyway, I'm going to say thank you for joining us tonight. We really, really appreciate it. Thank you, Karen, for coming. You've been an absolute superstar.
Thank you.
She's given me the whisper, there's even more new moulds.
I'm getting started this year.
I'm going to tell her she can't release any more until she's back here, so I will get the date. Okay. And thank you, Barry, for helping out.
No problem.
Thank you, John. Thank you, Maria. And if I don't see you on Thursday, have a super Easter. Otherwise, I'll see the rest of you on Thursday morning, 11 o'clock. Bye-bye. Bye.